Yoshimitsu is considered to be the finest of all Tanto painters, while Norishige made tremendous amount of Tantos. Yukimitsu's Tantos are great. Wataguchi's. But by and large, I believe the Japanese consider the Yoshimitsu to be the best.
One thing, most of these blades are Hira's Kuri, so very easy to see and enjoy the beautiful jigane and the utsuri. Sometimes more easier than a katana. So collectors like this type of tanto.
My teacher, Tanto Kennedy, used to say that making a tanto and getting everything right on that was the most difficult thing because of the fact that your eyes can look at a tanto and take in the whole thing, whereas if you make a daito and you're doing tsukuba or something, you make a blip on it, that it takes a while to see mistakes. So forth. So he says that always making tantos, he used to destroy many of them. I'd see him pull it out of the fire and look at it and then hit it on a stone a couple of times and then throw it into the trash pile. And, wow, what's the matter? It's not good enough, you know, because tanto, any flaw instantly show up when you pick it up and look at it. So you'll always find tantos in this caliber anyway, are super nice condition.
In terms of collecting, something to keep in mind for the popularity of tanto, that if you like gocho pieces and you like them signed, maybe even signed and dated, it's much easier to find that kind of condition in a tanto than an old long sword, because so many of the long swords have been shortened and lost their signatures. Out here today, I think there's a signed and dated Norishige and a signed and dated Right Kunitoshi, and it happens that both of them are said to be the earliest dated pieces by those Brahmin Smiths, so that's kind of